Hello everyone, welcome back to another introductory lecture video on the design of brakes. So as we all know, brake is a device which is used to retard or completely stop some moving element or some part of a machine, and that is with the help of artificial frictional resistance created. So while stopping or retarding this moving elements, the brake will be absorbing the kinetic energy, and that will be converted in the form of heat by means of friction, and this energy will be dissipated to the surrounding, so that excessive heating of this frictional material or lining doesn't occur. So here in this module we'll be learning about the design of different brakes, and based on this mechanism of transfer of kinetic energy to this heat energy, different types of brakes are there, and we'll be seeing that which are mechanical brakes, electrical brakes, hydraulic brakes, and pneumatic brakes, and many other categories are also there. But here we'll be studying the design of mechanical brakes in detail. So let's see what are mechanical brakes. So mechanical brakes are the one in which energy transformation, that means the kinetic energy to heat energy, is through the physical contact of mechanical system, and those type of brakes are called mechanical brakes. So mechanical system means that may include springs, levers, belt, pedals, pulleys, etc. So here we'll be talking or completely studying the design of this mechanical brakes only, and based on the constructional varieties, this mechanical brakes are of mainly four types, which are block or shoe brakes, band brakes, then this combination of first two, block and band brakes, and internal expanding brakes. So you can see the schematic figures of these four types here. So here in the first figure you can see the block type of brakes, or which are also known as shoe brakes. Here this is the brake drum which is getting retarded or completely stopped. And this motion or the kinetic energy of this block is being absorbed with the help of this material, which is in the form of a block or shoe. So which is containing the friction lining. This friction lining is made up of asbestos, wood, leather, cork, belt, ferrodos, etc. So here this will be, this block of material will be absorbing the energy, kinetic energy, by means of the frictional contact that is occurring here. Since it is in the form of a block, this is known as block brake. That is the first case. The detailed analysis of this block brakes by drawing the free body diagrams, force analysis, calculation of the frictional torque, everything will be done in the coming lectures. And in the second type of brakes, which is mechanical brakes, which is band brakes, here the frictional material or lining is in the form, which is used over this brake drum as the belt. So such kind of thing is known as band brakes. And third one, it is actually the combination of this block and band. So here over this brake drum or this rotating body, a number of blocks of this materials are arranged, and over the surface of this blocks the bands are coming. So this bands are attached, and the motion of this or the frictional contact can be affected with the help of this lever, which is attached, which is the type of mechanical brakes, block and band. And in the last type, which is known as an internal expanding brake, so here this is the brake drum whose motion is to be retarded or stopped, and here the frictional contact will be made with this friction lining, which can be moved onto the surface so that a contact can be generated over this area. So this kind of brakes, whose analysis also will also be discussed, that is known as internal expanding brakes. So these are the main four types of mechanical brakes which we require for this course. And as an introductory stage, you will have to study the different energy equations which may be required for solving the problems of brakes. So for understanding those energy equations, we'll be seeing a simple problem. So here we have a numerical, a 40 kilogram wheel 400 mm in diameter turning at 200 rpm is brought to rest by pressing a brake shoe radially against a rim with the force of 120 N. If the radius of gyration is 0.25 meter and coefficient of friction is 0.3, how many revolutions will the wheel make before coming to rest? So you can consider it as a simple basic introductory problem. So here you have a wheel which is rotating at 200 rpm. So it is having an initial angular velocity of 200 rpm. So this is omega 1 is given in n or rpm, so you can convert it in s 2 pi n by 60. So this will be giving you values in radians per second. So this will be getting as 20.94 radians per second, and it is brought to rest means its final velocity is omega 2, which is equal to 0. And for making it to rest or completely stop, here this is being pressed against this one by with the help of this shoe or this block, and it is pressed radially by applying a force of this radial force is 120 newton. So you will have to calculate the frictional force from this radial force given. So here the coefficient of friction is 0.3, so this radial, or you can consider as the normal force, so the frictional force will be perpendicular to normal force, and that frictional force you can calculate as F, which is equal to mu times the n. So this will be equal to 120 into 0.3, which is equal to 36 newton. So this frictional force is 36 newton, and now you can calculate the total kinetic energy possessed by the body initially. That will be equal to the rotational kinetic energy will be equal to half I omega 1 square. Since it is being brought to rest, it omega 2 is 0. Anyway, its final kinetic energy is half I omega 2 square. So its change in kinetic energy is half I, the higher energy, omega 1 square minus omega 2 square. So this is the change in kinetic energy, and this is to be absorbed by the brake. So energy absorbed by the brake is this half I into omega 1 square minus omega 2 square. Omega 1 is 20.94 and omega 2 is 0. And this will be absorbed by this brakes, and while retarding, this retardation of wheel from omega 1 to omega 2 is not happening at a moment. So while retarding, this wheel will be having some rotation, some number of rotations, or this will be undergoing some angular displacement. So let the angular displacement be theta, and this frictional force acting at this location will be creating a frictional torque about the center of this one. So if the frictional torque is T and this total angular displacement occurring for this wheel is theta, then the energy, changing energy, kinetic energy of the wheel can be equated to the work done by the frictional torque. So this can be equated to the frictional torque T into theta. So here you have to calculate the number of revolutions. That means here you have to calculate the angular displacement or the theta moved by the wheel before coming to rest. And here you know that this T is equal to the frictional force into radius. So here this is the radius. Its value is 200 mm or 0.2 meter. So you are having the frictional force. This frictional force is 36 newton into 0.2. So you can calculate the torque value. So in newton meter you will be getting. So this is in newton meter. So this next you have to substitute for the I value. So I is the mass moment of inertia, which is equal to m k square, where this m is the mass of this rotating, which is 40 kilogram, and k is the radius of gyration for this rotating body. And here they have given the radius of gyration as 0.25 meter. So this is 0.25 square. You are having the value of mass moment of inertia. Omega 1 is 20.94, omega 2 is 0. So you can calculate the E value. So E value is known, and on the right hand side torque T is known. So the remaining thing is theta. So you can calculate the total angular displacement in radians from this one. So theta will be equal to E by T. So total angular displacement is theta, and here they are asking the number of revolutions the wheel will make before coming to rest. So in one revolution, it will be making an angle of 2 pi radians. So the total number of revolutions, we have to evaluate. So number of revolutions will be equal to theta divided by 2 pi, where this theta is coming, you will be obtaining in radians, and the as such you have to substitute here. So this theta will be in radians and divided by 2 pi, which is actually 2 into 3.14 radians. Then you will be getting the number of cycle. So if you are solving this one, you will be getting approximately a value of 12. That means by undergoing from an initial velocity of omega 1 to rest 0, this wheel will be making 12 number of cycles before it is coming to rest under the action of this frictional force applied by this block. So this is showing you only the introductory energy equations which are required, energy equations, frictional torque, frictional force, and the number of cycles for the angular displacement. And this basic concept can be used and developed for solving the more complex analysis of the mechanical brakes, which is mentioned earlier. So hope you understood, and thanks for watching.